Welcome back. In the last two videos, we have added user sign up and user sign in. In this video, I want to make sure that we can also protect our routes. We have this token that we can store on our client. Now I want to make sure that we can use that token to access certain routes on our backend that are protected. So it's time to add some protection. We have our products and our orders routes. There are some routes that we don't want to protect, for example, getting all products. That makes sense to be an unprotected route, because if we were to create a frontend for our shop here, we probably want to be able to view all our products, even for unauthenticated users. The same is true for a get route to a specific product. Typically, we want to allow our users to get more product information. However, other routes, like creating a new product or deleting products or changing them, and maybe all order related routes, including the get route here, are protected routes. We want to make sure that not every user can access them. And therefore, we need some way to protect these routes. A good approach will be a middleware, which we can easily add to our route. When this middleware runs, it determines, does it make sense to continue or the user isn't authenticated. So let's create a new class. We can name it explicitly – Protected Route. The idea is the following. This middleware wraps a protected middleware. When the request arrives, we verify the token. If everything is OK, we call the wrapped middleware. But if there is no valid token, we immediately return an unauthorized response. So the constructor accepts a private key, it will be needed to verify the token, and a middleware or a controller that should be wrapped and thus be protected. Then in method invoke, we handle the request. Once the request arrives, we check the token. If it is valid, then we execute the wrap middleware. Otherwise, we return an unauthorized response. Let's add method authorize. Here we get an authorization header from the request. We extract a token from the header value. If it is empty, we return false. Then try to decode the token. Call a static method decode and pass a token, a private key, and an algorithm. We use HS256. If the result of decoding is null, it means that the token is not valid. That's it. I don't want to manually create instances of this class for each route. It will become a bit messy passing all the time the secret key. Let's instead create a sort of factory, a guard, which will be responsible for wrapping our controllers into protected routes. Create a new class guard, the constructor accepts a secret key. Then comes one public method protect. It accepts a middleware and returns a protected route. Inside, we wrap a passed controller into an instance of the protected route. OK, now we need to initialize the guard and then wrap all protected controllers inside. Open server.php and we start wrapping. We use a secret key from the environment variable. Protect the route here, when we create a new product. Then here, when we delete and update a product. And all order related routes. That's it. OK, save this and let's try. Open requests file. At first, we need to sign up. Here we receive a token in the response. I don't want to copy and paste it each time I need it. So let's use PHP Storm global variables and save it. After the request body, we type client.global.set and the name of the global that we want to use. I call it token, and the field from the response. In our case, it is also called token. Send this request once again. Nothing changes, but with that, now we have a stored token in the global variable. So let's try to request all orders. As expected, we receive a 401 response. But now let's send our token with the request. To do it, we provide an authorization header and use our stored variable with token. Now, if I send this, I get a list of orders. So this is how we can use the token, how we added our middleware, which can now conveniently add to any route that should be protected. And we are using a JSON web token concept for this authentication flow and for making sure that the client can be identified by a server and can access protected resources without the server having to store any information about the connected clients. This is now true stateless authentication implemented in our React PHP server. Now with that, we made a huge step forward. We added authentication. And now it's up to you to continue building this API. Of course, our tokens are not completely secure. To protect our API, we can add refresh tokens, we can implement throttling. There is a lot of stuff there. I hope you enjoyed this series and you have learned about how you can build a RESTful service with React PHP.